હવે જોઈએ આપણે તો પહેલા માહિતી માહિતી આપણે જોઈ લઈએ અને માહિતી આપતા પહેલા હું તમને જેટલા દિવસ આપણા કોર્સ ચાલશે હું કે તમે ગુજરાતી ને પણ હિન્દી ઓર ઇંગ્લિશ કોર્સ પ્રાઇમરી છે એનો હું તમને અત્યારે સમજાવું છું ફાવે તો ઇંગ્લિશમાં બોલવાનું અધરવાઇઝ હિન્દીમાં બોલવાનું બરાબર છે ઇંગ્લિશ ફ્લુએન્સી કોર્સ ઇસકા મતલબ ક્યા હૈ પહેલે તો એ ફ્લુએન્સી ક્યા હૈ વોટ ઇઝ ધ મીનિંગ ઓફ ફ્લુએન્સી ફ્લુએન્સી મીન્સ વિધાઉટ हेजिटेशन खच काट वगर बिना हिचकिचाहट के दैट इज व्हाट हेजिटेशन मीन्स राइट फ्लुएंसी हैज एवरीथिंग टू डू विद स्पोकन It has nothing to do with written. So what we mean of fluency, it means only about spoken. It has nothing to do with written. Because writing English, we have spent lot of time Probably from second to now we are going to get admission in Allahabad. So many years we have spent writing. Has it helped us to speak? No. We haven't even experienced. Some of you have experienced. Most of the students haven't experienced speaking English. Or whenever we tried, we have said one or two or three or more than five sentences and then we lack of topic, we lack topic, we forget about topic and we stop that point. And we immediately come to the point that we don't know English. That is different. We know English, but we come to the point, we immediately decide that our English is weak. Actually, we commit mistake there. Actually, we don't lack the knowledge of English. We lack the topic, we lack the planning, we lack what we should say scholar. We lack here. We have a lot of words in English. We have learned lot of grammar topics in English and we are capable of speaking it. The only thing we need is confidence. Sir, what is the difference between spoken and written? In dono mein kya antar hai? So written to hum udte hain, khate hain, पीते हैं सोते हैं उड़ते जागते सब इसके साथ हमने पिछले 10 साल किया इट इज नॉट न्यू फॉर अस है ना ये हमारे लिए नई बात नहीं व्हाट इज न्यू स्पोकन इवन इंग्लिश मीडियम स्टूडेंट्स फाइंड इट डिफिकल्ट टू स्पीक दे नो प्रॉब्लम मोर About English than even teacher or even other Gujarati medium student, but they find it difficult because they haven't practiced it. See, speaking two, three sentences, it is not English. Whatever you discuss about the topic from top to bottom without using other language, only in English. When your body helps you while speaking, then you are master of it. When you say yes, जब तुम यस बोलते हो तो तुम्हारा मुंह जो है इट शुड गो लाइक दिस. अदरवाइज व्हेन यू से समथिंग इन इंग्लिश एंड यू आर मोशनलेस देन व्हाट हैपन्स, यू डजंट साउंड, यू डोंट साउंड नेचुरल. व्हेन आई से डोंट, माय हैंड goes like this. It says that English is not a matter of worry for me because my body tells me, right? The spoken is different. Written, do you need your body? No. Yes, sir. Hands are there. Yes, but you say something like no, your body doesn't require to go in like this, moving your head, right? You say no, I know, and rest thing is done in your mind, right? But spoken is something different. What is the difference? क्या अंतर है इसमें? कोई बताएगा दो चार अंतर? कि सर दिस इज द डिफरेंस व्हेन वी राइट दिस इज द फैसिलिटी और दिस इज द ऑब्स्टेकल्स वी फेस और व्हेन वी स्पीक वी हैव दिस टाइप ऑफ एडवांटेजेस और डिसएडवांटेजेस इन स्पीकिंग इंग्लिश. एनीवन कैन रेज अ वन पॉइंट while writing, you have these advantages or those advantages. While speaking, you don't have those advantages. What is the advantage that you have in written but you don't have in spoken? What is that point? So we are talking about those differences now. We know, but we don't have exact words to say, right? No problem. Written. Written is totally based on, letters, alphabets, right? And when we write something, when we write our thoughts, हमारी सोच हम रखते हैं, तो हमारे पास बहुत सारा समय होता है. हम सोचते हैं, लिखते हैं, अगर पसंद नहीं आया तो मिटाते हैं, दोबारा रिपेयर करके लिखते हैं. वी हैव लॉट ऑफ टाइम बिकॉज देयर इज नोबडी देयर टू लिसन टू यू. सो फर्स्ट पॉइंट ऑफ डिफरेंस बिटवीन रिटन एंड स्पोकन इज वी हैव लॉट्स एंड लॉट्स ऑफ टाइम हियर. While writing, do you have that time when you speak? Because there is someone listening to you. He is a villain. He doesn't allow you a second or two more when you speak. So you have to manage time there. You have to manage, right? So no letters involved when we speak. Is there spelling involved? No. No letters involved. Here it is totally based on letters. Lots of time doesn't allow you time. Spontaneous means what? Spontaneous. Spontaneous means without prior planning. This is what I want every student to speak. If you go and learn a story from home and come here and then say that story, that is not your spoken language. वो तो तुम्हारी लैंग्वेज नहीं है, वो तो तुमने रट्टा मारा है. मगर प्रायर प्लानिंग यानी कि घर से कोई भी प्लानिंग नहीं किया और यहाँ आकर तुमने किसी भी टॉपिक पर बोला, वट एवर वर्ड्स आर अवेलेबल टू यू, यूजिंग दोज वर्ड्स टू योर एबिलिटी, यू कैन से एनीथिंग अबाउट दैट टॉपिक, दैट इज कॉल्ड स्पॉन्टेनियसिटी. Spontaneity doesn't need any knowledge, you know. Because knowledge makes you slave. आपको गुलाम बनाता है, हरदम आपको डरना है. नॉलेज तो डरना पड़ेगा और डर आएगा तो तुम क्या हो जाओगे, गुलाम. और गुलाम कभी राजा की गद्दी पर बैठ सकता है? नहीं, वो जो सूर्य आएगा जी जो जो भी टाइम काम मिला वो करके आ जाएगा. अगर नहीं हुआ तो रिपोर्ट करेगा, वो कभी राजा नहीं कर सकता. नॉलेज इज पावर. वी हैव रिसर्न्ड समवेयर बट इट मेक्स यू स्लेव ऑल्सो. ये पावर भी है और ये तुम्हें गुलाम भी बना. सर ये बाजू नहीं बोल रहा. इट कैन बी अ किंग और अ स्लेव, आइदर अ किंग और अ स्लेव. टाइम टू टाइम नॉलेज मेक्स यू अ किंग एंड सम टाइम्स आर देयर इट मेक्स यू स्लेव. As for example, you are now here to learn about English fluency course. You don't know everything about this course. You are learning. So this time, these knowledge, because you don't have any knowledge about this course, means you are slave. But when you complete and you try and practice speaking it, and you find some confidence in yourself, then you will slowly, slowly, from you turn or you shift yourself from being slave to king. Right? So time changes. Knowledge which was forcing you being slave, and when it changes, it makes you king. But time doesn't change this way. You have to give convenient time. तुम्हारे इन्हें तुमको उसे योग के समय देना होगा. And when you are giving time, it means patience. It means patience. Patience चाहिए. और पेशेंस इज अ पावरफुल वेपन. यू आर गोइंग टू बास्केट, हैज हैव यू डन इट इन 10 और 15 डेज? नो, यू हैव गिवन मेजोरिटी ऑफ टाइम ऑफ योर लाइफ टू पास. इट मीन्स पेशेंस. नहीं नहीं, मुझे तो फर्स्ट में दस भी चाहिए बस. वही शांति रख दिमाग मत कर, पुनीत मेरा नहीं चला इतनी उतार मत कर. ऐसा नहीं हो सकता. इट इज नॉट इन आवर कंट्रोल. एंड समथिंग व्हेन देयर इज नॉट इन आवर कंट्रोल, वी शुड डील दैट पॉइंट्स विद पेशेंस. Because we don't have anything else to give. Patience. And then 10 years pass, you will have your whatever dream you had seen of passing with flying colors will be there knocking your doors. Hello, Vishwa, where are you? I'm your 10th mark sheet. And science has one leg broken. See that? And what about the standard meds, sir? Standard meds has no any legs, no hands, even cannot see. It is on the border. Yes, I was expecting. Okay. Written language, it is not new, because we have been doing these things since we started learning English. We started writing A, B, C, D. It is not new for us. Okay? So, it is not a matter of what. We can write any amount of words if we are given a topic to write essay on this and beta aap to shanti rah beta aap to shanti barabar. So written is something we don't need to worry about, but when we are talking about spoken, it is something new, right? It is not so old for us, so we find it difficult. It is about timing. It is actually not difficult. Both are English. Both are English, or is it Urdu? Both are English. When we find nothing difficult while writing, why should we bother about it while speaking? Right? So we have enough knowledge. We have enough knowledge while dealing with it. So it is not to worry for us about speaking, right? Have you ever written short notes, question answer, essay, email? Means you have a lot of words to express your ideas. So it is something which will help you speak. It is saying that you are well enough, you are prepared enough to speak. Right? So don't worry about spoken language. Written is always easier than spoken. It is always easier than spoken. Because see, why is it so? Written हमेशा spoken से सरल रहता है. क्यों? क्योंकि पहले तो सामने वाला कोई सुनने वाला नहीं होता है. जब सामने वाला आता था हम ही होते, वो तेरी करता. अब ये दोनों काम में क्या है, नंबर तो देना है उसको, नंबर दे तो दो चार अच्छा लिखा तो अच्छे नंबर दे. तो रिटर्न में हमको ये सब फैसिलिटी है. दूसरा, रिटर्न में हम ऑर्गन्स क्या होते, तो बताएगा ऑर्गन्स क्या है. इंग्लिश मीडियम ऑर्गन्स का मतलब क्या होता है, उर्दू मीडियम गुजराती मीडियम. What is organ? We have lot of organs in our body. Body parts. Body organs.
English
word? Organs. English words. Organs are English words. Body parts, English word. Right? We have lot of organs in our body. Which some of them are helpful while speaking? Speech organs. बोलने के अंग, इसको भी हमें जानना है. जब हम बोलते हैं तो हमारी एनर्जी कहां से आती है, थॉट प्रोसेस कहां चलती है और कौन कौन से ऑर्गन्स है व्हिच हेल्प अस साउंड अवर लैंग्वेज मोर नेचुरल। कौन कौन से ऑर्गन्स है जो हमको हेल्पफुल होते हैं? एक तो मतलब ब्रेन, एक्चुअली इट इज नॉट स्पीच ऑर्गन, इट इज हेल्पफुल इन थॉट प्रोसेस। वी डोंट से अ वर्ड यूजिंग ब्रेन, वी थिंक। हाँ विचारी सूत तो बोली सू, ए बोली सू ए विचार वाला नदी आवतो ना, त्यारे ब्रेन स्टॉप थई जाय। व्हेन यू थिंक समथिंग इट इज हेल्प्ड बाय ब्रेन, बट व्हेन यू स्पीक ब्रेन थिंक्स अबाउट समथिंग एल्स, इट डजंट हेल्प यू स्पीकिंग। माउथ, बॉडी ना पार्ट्स से आप बोलवाना है, बॉडी के कौन से पार्ट्स? यू हैव अ पावरफुल ऑर्गन व्हाइल स्पीकिंग योर आई। इट सेज मोर देन व्हाट यू से विद द हेल्प ऑफ माउथ, राइट? हैंड, फिंगर्स, दीज ऑल आर स्पीच ऑर्गन्स, राइट? जब हम गुजराती बोलते हैं इनकी कोई जरूरत नहीं पड़ती, क्यों? क्योंकि हम गुजराती पढ़कर नहीं सीखे, हम गुजराती सीख गए फिर पढ़ना शुरू हो गया। बट इन इंग्लिश इट इज टोटल रिवर्स, we started learning English first in school and then we never tried speaking it, so it is very easy for us, sir it is difficult for us, okay? When you try speaking it, when you try making a pause, you will be supposed to make some mistakes, right? जारे भी तुमने अंग्रेजी बोलो, हम बोलूं तुमने बोलो, expert बोले, अमिताभ बच्चन बोले, कोई भी बोले, because we don't find that much time while speaking, it is quite possible that a person can it may make mistakes. It is natural. Barabar hai. So we first of all don't need to worry about mistakes because Amitabh too makes mistakes. Narendra Modi is there in a queue. Musk, the richest person of the world, it is also there in a queue. The bigger the person, the number of amount of mistakes will be more and more there. We are not that much bigger. We are not supposed to do that much mistakes. Means the amount of mistakes will be quite less. Got it? Sir, are they such a big person, Amitabh, Modi, Musk, Zuckerberg, are they worrying about their mistakes? Never. So should we? Should never. अटली बड़ी इतनी सारी गलतियों के बावजूद दे आर नॉट वरी वाई शुड बी, तो हमको क्यों मतलब इतनी चिंता करनी, समझ गए? तो पहली बात तो क्या करना है, सीना चौड़ा करके निकलना है, आजा सामने मैदान में ले आठ दस गलती ले सुबह शाम दोपहर ये वो फलाना झुमका पूछ रहा बराबर, गलतियां करो, do mistakes, because mistakes make और mistakes teach you, गलतियां तुम्हें सिखाती है। कोई आदमी पहले से परफेक्ट होके आता है, पहला हुआ न्यू बॉर्न बेबी बोलता है मम्मी इधर नाश्ता ला रहा है और परोठा मत करना जलता है, दूध में शक्कर डाल के लाना है, ऐसा कोई परफेक्ट आदमी नहीं है, बट बाय एंड बाय अब वो जब सीख जाता है, उसके पास कोई मीडियम है, कोई प्लेटफॉर्म है, कोई स्कूल है, वो बच्चा छोटा है देखता है इसके मम्मी क्या बोल रहे, इसके पप्पा क्या बोल रहा है, he has just one platform and that is
classification
and observation, that is ears. A baby is such a small child. He or she doesn't need a classification or whatever you say. He just listens. The only platform he or she has is a platform of hearing. केवल सुनकर सीख जाता है और सीख ही नहीं जाता, वो जॉक्स भी मारता है उसमें, वो हंसता भी है किसी को देखकर, गुस्सा भी होता है, सभी फीलिंग्स आती है। क्या वो स्कूल में गया होता है, कोई टीचर ने बताया होता है? हाँ सर, ये बात तो सही है, सोचा नहीं कभी, क्योंकि उस वो समय वो सीख नहीं रहा है, उसने देखना और सुनना शुरू कर दिया है, एंड मोटिव इज नॉट अबाउट लर्निंग, मोटिव इज डायरेक्टली टू स्पीक, ग्रामर सीखता है वो। बुक्स में देखो न्यू ग्लोसरी कौन सी है, वर्ड्स क्या है, इसका मीनिंग क्या है, एक्सेप्ट और सी एक्सेप्ट द थिंग्स वॉट एवर इट इज, कभी मीनिंग कभी नहीं, स्पोकन ऐसी बात, इट हैज नथिंग टू डू विद रिटर्न। आने नावा नहीं चोर समझ ना दी, नदी आवड़ो खुश खाओ, आवड़े दे खुश खाओ, केम आना आनी सारी नहीं लेवा जाए, अने आ આટલી પણ અતિશયોક્તિ નથી હતી, અમેરિકા મારે ફ્રેન્ડ ગયો હતો, કોન્સર્ટ ટીચર અમારો સ્કૂલમાં દીધો, ત્યાં એને લગતા ની આડે નામ આપવા અંગ્રેજી, પણ ત્યાં બે વર્ષ સ્ટોરમાં કામ કરી જાય, ગ્લુકોઝ ઓકે પાલે પાલે હેવ અ નાઇસ ડે સર ઓકે બાય, this is what the spoken, but ask him to write the spelling of goodbye, he had never jana dimag kharab kar raha hai, ye nahi tha a example so liye, what is this example showing, this example starts showing that it has nothing to do with return, if you are given total environment of speaking English you are not left with the option, you will probably start speaking it, but because you have a lot of options here, you can use Gujarati, Hindi, you can put yourself on mute mode, these are the options available, they push you being away from the English, but you are not left with any option and you have to speak English, you will probably start speaking it in 5 or 7 days and it is Correct. Because he is speaking the only English language. So his thought process will start thinking in English. So he'll probably find the exact word to express his ideas. Right? You have to go to the next level. And the next level doesn't require any hard work. Just need a force. Let me decide, I'm not going to lose Gujarati. This is what the effort is. Let me decide, I'm not going to speak Hindi. These are the efforts required. And these are not Bhayankar efforts. Whatever we say in English, and we are expected to do many mistakes too. Don't bother about it. When you have mistakes, you will have chances to correct it. Will you have any chance to correct anything else? No, because you are not committing mistakes. गलती करोगे तो उसको रिप्लाई